1, 2, 3. Hey guys! Okay, so today I did this full face and makeup. Today is my boyfriend and I 3-year anniversary, so we're going out tonight. I tried out a ton of new products today, like a lot of drugstore stuff too. So if you want to see how I got this look and my opinion on some of the products, go ahead and keep on watching. Okay, here we go. I don't really know what kind of look I want to do tonight. Just something, nothing too crazy, but still like a full glam look because obviously I'm going to dinner, so I gotta look good. I'm gonna start with a new brow pencil. I'm gonna use the Balm Cosmetics Ferocious Brow Pencil. This is in the shade Dark Brown. I have not tried this, so this is my first time using it. It has a skinny tip just like my usual brow pencil. I usually use the Benefit Precisely My Brow Pencil. But I'm gonna try something new. Hopefully this is dark enough. This is the darkest shade, I believe. I did just dye my hair even darker, so my hair is like almost black. It's a little bit too light, but I can make it work. It's very pigmented and it's not like skipping or anything. I'm liking it. I'm just gonna do a rough outline for now and then fix them up later. So far so good with this. I have nothing bad to say about it except the color's just a little bit too light, but that's not their fault. I think I'm gonna keep the eyes pretty light today, nothing too heavy or black. So I'm gonna actually do my foundation first. If I was gonna do heavy eyeshadow, then I would do my eyes first, but I wanna do foundation. Got it. So I have a primer from NYX I wanna try. This is the Honey Do Me Up Primer. Never tried this before. I believe it's probably a dewy primer. So I'm gonna use something a little bit pore filling underneath it. I'm just gonna take a little bit of Porefessional. I'm just gonna press that right in the center of my face. Okay, now I'm gonna take the NYX one. It looks like the YSL Blur Primer. Like, that's what the inside looks like. Like, my face feels kind of dry after I put that on. Okay. Well, moving on. For foundation, I'm gonna use my current favorite, which is the Maybelline Superstay in the shade 220. And I'm gonna use the new Sigma 3D Sponge. They just relaunched this. They kind of updated the texture of it. So yeah, today is Peter and I's 3-year anniversary, which is absolutely crazy to me. And we're going to Urban Fondue, which is my favorite place ever. I love fondue. I think it's so freaking good. So that's where we're going tonight. Why does this look, this looks extra dark on me today. What? So my foundation's looking like extra orange today and I don't know why. Also, not loving the sponge. It's a little too hard. It's not as bouncy as I would like it to be. It just feels like I'm hitting my face, but I'm gonna keep using it for this look just to get my use out of it. I'm gonna try a new concealer that's new to me. This is the NYX HD Studio Concealer, and I have the shade 03. Hopefully, I think it'll be good under the eyes. I've never used this concealer, but I think I've heard good things about it, so hopefully it goes well. And I'm gonna use the curved side of the sponge for this. Okay, that blended out super quick. Whew. It looks really like hydrating under my eye. It actually looks really, really good. And I'm gonna set that with a little bit of translucent powder. Okay, the sponge is perfect for getting under the eye. I don't love it for foundation, but for this purpose, beautiful. The concealer's not as full coverage as I would like. I would definitely call it more of a light to medium finish, but that's fine, I can totally build it up. And then I'm bringing the powder up on my eyelids to prime it for eyeshadow. I'm also gonna use a concealer to kind of brighten the center of my face since my foundation's looking really dark. Concealer looks pretty good on my skin. I like it. I have another NYX product to try. It is the Wonder Stick. Never used this before either. This is the universal color, so hopefully it works with my orange face today. So you have a contour on one side and then a highlighter that I fucked up on the other side. I'm gonna try the contour first. Usually I'm not a big fan of cream contours, so we'll see how this goes. I'm just gonna do like one side of my face first and see what I think of it. I don't know if it's really dark enough for me. It is really creamy. It's not like a dry formula. Okay, the sponge is good though for the cream contour as well, just because it has that nice flat shape to it. It's definitely a natural contoured look, but I need a little bit more than that. Give me a minute. Okay, so that Wonder Stick did absolutely nothing for me. So I went ahead and just applied some NARS Laguna bronzer all over my outer perimeters of my face, just to bronze myself up. I do want to bake under my contour, so I'm gonna take the Maybelline Fit Me Loose powder. I'm taking it on the side of the sponge, so we can go like, oh. I'm gonna bake my nose too. Gonna leave that on for a little bit. I'm gonna take a newer blush palette to me. This is the Profusion Blush 6 color blush palette. It looks really pretty. I'm gonna take the shade Alive on a Sigma F10. Definitely has shimmer to it. I'm gonna add a tiny bit of Juicy, which is that bright corally one. I do not like shimmery blush. This does not look good on my pores. Today is a shit show. I'm gonna brush away this baggage. This blush looks so bad. It looks so ashy. You can see all of my pores. Oh my goodness. Whose idea was it to try new products on a date night? I have a new highlighter I want to try, so hopefully something goes well. This is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder. This is the shade Golden Flower Crown. It's like a really pretty gold champagne color. Let's hope this goes fine. Okay, I'm gonna fix my eyebrows real quick and then let's move on to the eyes. I'm gonna go into the ColourPop Give It To Me Straight palette, and on a Sigma E38, I'm gonna take Truth Hurts, and I'm just gonna run that through my crease. On the same brush, I'm gonna take Downright, and I'm gonna use that to softly blend out the edges. And then I'm gonna bring a mix of those two shades on my lower lash line. Now I'm gonna take the Urban Decay eyeliner in Demolition, and I'm gonna run that all along like my waterline and my lashes. Now on a Sigma E30S, I'm gonna take Actually, and I'm gonna use that to smoke out the eyeliner. And once that's kind of smudged out like that, I'm gonna take more of that Truth Hurt shade, that first shade we took, and I'm gonna use that to blend out the lower part of the eyeliner. Then I'm gonna take the eyeliner at my top lash line. This very messily like that. And I'm gonna do the same exact thing. So I'm smudging it out first with the brush and then taking the darker shade on top. And now I'm gonna use Downright to smoke it out. Now I'm gonna take a black gel eyeliner. I'm gonna use the Sigma Wicked Gel Liner. And I'm gonna take it on a little brush. This is an E75. And I'm gonna run that in my waterline and my tight line. Now I'm gonna pop on some mascara and lashes. So for lashes, I use the style Hypnotic from Morphe. And I went ahead and highlighted my eye with a shade up front from the palette on my inner corner and my brow bone. And here's the eyes all done. I love the eyes. I love having a smoky eyeliner on the top and the bottom. Big lashes, I'm happy with that. I also went ahead and added that up front shade to like my cheekbones just because I wanted a little more to my highlight. That Wet n Wild one was just like almost too dark for me. Let's finish off the lips. I have two shades to choose from Urban Decay. This first one is Fuel 2.0. The next one is just Fuel. So that one's a little more orangey. I think I wanna do the first one. I'm gonna do Fuel 2.0. Okay, I am loving that color. That is beautiful, yes. And I'm gonna finish off with some Fix Plus. Boyfriend. Hi.
Hey.
I have to go get my boyfriend. We will be right back. Give me 30 minutes. Okay, I found him. Ta-da! This is Peter.
Hi, guys.
This is my boyfriend.
This is me.
Mmm.
Cheez-Its.
And this is the final look. What do you guys think? Okay, most of the new products I tried totally sucked today. The Honey Dew Me Up Primer did nothing to my face. It made me feel like more dry. The concealer was pretty good. It was just more of a lighter coverage than I would want. Definitely lighter than Shape Tape or the ColourPop one that I usually use. The new sponge was okay too. It just feels a little hard when it's doing foundation, but it was really good for under the eyes, for concealer, and for baking. I did not like the Wonder Stick. It was too light, did nothing for my skin. I didn't even bother using the highlighter side because I just knew it wouldn't work. The Balm Brow Pencil was pretty good too. It was really similar to my Benefit one. Nothing bad to say about this. The Wet n Wild highlighter was pretty good too. It was almost just a little too dark for my skin tone. I could pick up a lighter shade, but I do like the finish of it. It's not like too glittery or anything. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Yep, that's it.
You just go, hey guys?
You just go, hey guys.
And then you get right into it.
And then you get into it. See, it's my blush that looks bad. It's like shiny right here, but it shouldn't be shiny there.
That's, it's like rosy.
It's like, is it too rosy?
Well, depends on who you're asking, I guess.
You like blush, right?
I don't think it's too rosy.
Hey guys, my name is Angela. I do the makeups.
I don't need your Cheez-Its rustling in the background.
You can't blame your foundation because you use self-tanner on your face.
Shh. Get out of here. Oh, thank you.